Shringeri is a small and very beautiful town on the banks of the river Tunga in Karnataka. The weather is very, very pleasant, and many people go there for the weather, but they certainly go because it is so closely associated with the great saint Adi Shankara, the propounder of the Advaita system of philosophy. It is said that one day Shankara was walking along that path when it was, of course, very, very much a forest and not as built up as it is today. And he saw this remarkable sight of a snake giving protection by raising its hood to a small frog that was giving birth to tadpoles, to eggs. And Shankara was amazed that two animals that were sworn enemies to each other could become so friendly. And immediately he stayed there and he started teaching his students. And the temple for Sharadambika was built there. The temple of Sharadamba is a combination of Devi and Saraswati, Durga and Saraswati. And there's a very interesting story for Sharada that comes in the old texts. Once upon a time, Shiva was really, really angry. And when he was so angry, he opened his third eye and he created, and all his anger came out in the form of this huge flame. Looking at the flame itself, the asura against whom that anger was directed died. But that anger was still all-consuming and it was still uncontrollable. And many, many people in the world and the Devaloka started getting very worried. And they were all running for their lives. There was utter chaos. And there was a complete confusion and terror at this anger that was almost going to heat up everything. The only person who was very calm was Saraswati. And she only said one thing. She said, why should we be worried about the anger? The anger is directed against those who are corrupt, those who are evil. And if we don't have any evil within us, if we've always done the right thing, then we are free from this anger destroying us. But of course, you know what the human mind is. We are always thinking negatively of ourselves. So many, many people were worried about it. And Saraswati understood that. So she was able to turn herself into a river. And she was able to hold on to that anger, which was in the form of a fire. And that river went all the way down to the ocean. And then she drew the anger into the ocean as a fire and took her right to the bottom of the ocean. In the bottom of the ocean, that anger was turned into a beautiful horse called Badavagni. And she promised the horse that he has to stay there. And the horse agreed that he will stay there as anger and in that horse's form and come up only when the entire world was completely corrupt, was completely evil. The wealthy people were not sharing their wealth with others. The powerful people were not protecting the weak. And the whole order of Srishti, Sthiti and Laya, that is creation, stabilization and ending towards a new order, was not being followed. And Badavagni continued to stay there. In that way, Saraswati was able to save the world and save people from themselves. And this is why she was also called Sharada, and that is a deity in the Shringeri temple. She's Sharadambika, and people worship her as both as an aspect of Durga and Ambika and as an aspect of Saraswati, the goddess of learning. So when we look back in our own lives, we are hearing the words of Sharada when we are able to control our senses and we are able to, you know, enjoy the beauty of the world around us, enjoy the senses, but also not become a prisoner to them. But the day we allow our senses to rule our behavior rather than our behavior ruling over our senses, in that day, our refuge in Sharada has diminished, and there is a chance that we will also start feeling upset and angry and scared about Badavagni coming outside. So my hope is we continue to have Sharada within our minds and our hearts and control our senses, be watchful of our senses, and not allow our senses to overtake us.